I'm here inside the locker room at Dallas Cowboys Stadium with Salvador Sanchez, who just won his fight, knocking his opponent down twice in a sixth round.
Let me know when you're ready.
How did you knock him down? And then he went down one, and then the second time,
en el segundo,
he goes a body shot, and he just took him out. It's complete.
That's how he shadow boxes?
Nah.
He's like dancing.
He's showing
dancing.
Off for you, baby.
He's showing off for you.
That's what it's called?
Show off. Yeah, he's showing off to you.
Man, he's like a bullfighter. Your uncle.
Tu tío.
Is a legend.
Es una leyenda.
Now, every day you look more and more like him. What do people tell you now that your name's getting out there?
Que cada día te ves más y más como tu tío. ¿Qué dices con el nombre de él?
Híjole, bueno, pues, como siempre lo digo, la verdad me siento honrado de que me comparen con él, una gran personalidad boxística.
He says it's an honor to always be, you know, identified by, for at him, identified
with his uncle Salvador Sanchez,
with his uncle, yes, his uncle Salvador Sanchez, the late legend of Mexico, probably the best fighter that ever came out of Mexico, and he says it's, he said that it's wonderful to be comparable to him, but in time, you know, it's good that they compare me. You know?
And is he working out again now? He just finished fighting.
Yeah, he's gonna go again. No, someone wanted a rep.
Oh, so. It's a souvenir.
That's a souvenir, so I gotta make him a rep.
That's cool. I thought he's gonna go fight again. Yeah, like they need a guy, like in basketball, they're nine guys, they're missing one. Let's go.
No.
Creía que ibas a pelear otra vez.
Oh, yes. No, sí, vamos por la segunda.
He says he is. He's going to come out again, and he's going to be the last bout again.
Mexican fighters, Julio Cesar Chavez, other fighters, they don't mind getting hit. They don't mind. Does that hurt?
Dice que como los peleadores con Julio Cesar Chavez y ellos, no les importa que les peguen. ¿Que te duele cuando te pegaron?
Oh, no, yo creo que desde que entramos a este deporte sabemos que estamos dispuestos a eso, a que nos peguen una que otra marquita, pero son gajes del oficio, no hay ningún problema.
He says it's part of the job, you know, being a fighter, but it's nothing big, you know, he's used to that.
What's he saying?
Hey, little tricks, man, we can't really reveal them, they're Ruben's tricks, man, you know, but it's good stuff.
It's all good.
It's all good.
Ruben, how far do you see him going now?
There's a lot of future with him. But it's a lot to learn. He needs to learn a lot still. He's still in the learning stages. But in time, he will become a great fighter. I'm not going to compare him to his uncle, but hopefully, you know, something will come close to his uncle.
He's 19-3-2 with 11 knockouts. What do you think about the following that he has because his uncle, because his fighting?
That.
Let me tell you, the following will probably get bigger in time just because he's learning. He's a fighter, like I said before, he's a fighter that you don't, I would love to have 10 of these fighters because I don't have no problem in training. I this is a fighter that does not cry, does not, you know, complain. I could tell this guy to do 20 miles and he'd go out and do them and he'd come back and ask me, what else you want me to do?
Oh.
What's his message to his fans, to his uncle's fans?
¿Qué mensaje le das a tus fanáticos, tus gente que te viene a ver?
No, pues los invito a que no pierdan mi carrera, que no me pierdan, que sigan mi carrera y que les guste, que por mí voy a entregar todo, estoy entregando todo en este deporte y espero se queden satisfechos.
He said that he would hopefully his fans will follow him to whatever limits he's going to be, you know, get to, and that he always will put everything out. He'll always put on a good fight, the best fight he can for his fans.
There you have it, Salvador Sanchez, a spitting image of his uncle, Salvador Sanchez, from Dallas Stadium in Texas. I'm Eli Sekbak, reporting.